Hello everyone, I hope you're doing well, wherever you're watching me from. Now today I want us to focus on a type or a store of energy. Remember, energy is defined as the ability to do work. Energy can exist as either a store or can either exist as a transfer. So today I want us to focus on this store of energy that is called mechanical energy. So the question is, what is mechanical energy? So mechanical energy can be defined as the energy stored in a material or an object due to its motion or position, and this position is with respect to the ground. Now, this brings to your attention the forms or the stores of energy that you can able to remember. Energy that is associated with the motion of an object, that is called the kinetic energy. And then energy that is associated with the position of an object with respect to the ground, and that one we are now talking about the gravitational potential energy, or you can call it EP, this one you can call EK. So I want us to look at this one by one, that is kinetic energy and GPE in details. So let's start with the kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy of an object is defined as the energy stored in that moving object and depends on its mass and its speed. So what I want us to do is to show how do we calculate kinetic energy. Now consider a body moving from point A to, let's say, point B. So a body is moving from point A to point B. So if we assume that at point A, its initial speed is u meters per second, and at point B, its initial, at point B, the speed is v meters per second. Now, A to B, the displacement is, let's just use d. Displacement between A to B, the displacement is d, or we can use s, we can use x, but you can just use d for that matter. Now, for us to define kinetic energy, for a body to move from point A to point B, that means work must be done. So work done in moving the object from point A to point B will be equal to the energy transferred to the object. And this energy transferred to the object, if the speed is increasing, that means there will be a gain in kinetic energy. There will be a gain in kinetic energy. So remember, work is defined as force multiplied by distance. So work is the product of force and distance in the direction of force. Now, from here, this is a side note. So from here, we know that force F, the resultant force that is able to make an object move from point A to point B, is given by the product of mass and acceleration. While D, as the displacement, can be given by average velocity, that is U plus V divided by 2. So the average velocity multiplied with time T. So from here, to substitute, where we have F, we are going to substitute MA. So this will be MA times displacement here, which are represented by D. So that will be U plus V over 2 times T. Remember, if we want acceleration is given by V minus U over T. Acceleration is given by V minus U over T. So from here, work done work done in moving the object from point A to point B is given by M, and where we have A is given by V minus U over T, and then you multiply with the displacement, which is the average velocity, U plus V over 2 times T. Now you can see clearly, because these are multiplication, so T will cancel T. So we will have M into V minus U times U plus V, and this all over 2. Now, this mathematical identity. Remember, if you have from algebra, if you have X minus Y multiplied by X plus Y, can be prove this to give you that this will be X squared minus Y squared. So we don't need to waste time. So V minus U times U plus V, that will be given as V squared minus U squared. So the work done in moving the object from point A to point B, that is M into V squared minus U squared, and this multiplied by a half, or we divide by 2 for that matter. This work done, as we have mentioned here, is equal to the gain in kinetic energy. So the gain in kinetic energy, we can use EK or just KE for everyone. So kinetic energy is given by a half times M into V squared minus U squared. Now, if we assume, suppose this initial velocity or initial speed is zero. So if initial speed is zero, if U is equal to zero, then kinetic energy will be given by a half mv squared. And this is the equation that we always use to calculate kinetic energy. So kinetic energy will be given by a half mv squared, where m is the mass of the object that is in motion, and this must be in kilogram, and then v is the speed of the object, which must be in meters per second, or you can write as meters per second, like that. So if you're using this equation, ensure that you have to convert mass into kg and v into meters per second. So without wasting So gravitational potential energy, short form GPE, or we can use EP to represent gravitational potential energy, depending on which curriculum you are taking. So energy stored in an object which is raised from the ground. So suppose, let's say there is the ground and you're raising an object to a certain height. So let's say this is the object that has been raised, so from the ground, so that is head, so it has been raised from the ground to somewhere here. Now for this object here, maybe it is a stone. For this stone to be raised from the ground to where it is, work must be done. So how do you define work? Work is defined by the product of force and the distance in the direction of force. Now, the force you are dealing with here is the weight. The force you want to apply is the weight of this object. Weight, remember, weight which is having W is given by mg. That is mass times gravitational field strength, or acceleration due to gravity. So the force here is mg. The distance here covered is a vertical displacement. So we will use h to represent the vertical distance, or the vertical displacement. So that is h. So the work done in raising the object from the ground to where it is, to this vertical height, is given by mgh. And remember, the work done, this work done in raising the object is equal to gain in GPE, gravitational potential energy. If the object is moving from the top to down, that means that there will be loss in GPE and can be given by the same formula. So therefore, GPE is given by MGH. As I've said, we can use even EP to represent GPE. So that is MGH. Now, you must note that for you to use this formula here, note that M is the mass of the object that is being raised. This mass must always be in kilogram, the S unit of mass. Then G, depending on your level and the curriculum, in secondary level, we'll always use G as 10 Newton per kilogram. In syllabus, and mostly in A-level, we use, or depending on the syllabus you're taking, we'll use 9.81 Newton per kilogram. Even some books, they just use 9.8. Remember, this depends on the instruction that you've been given. These are constant and will always be given in the question paper. So you use the value that you've been given to work out G. As long as you use it, you'll get it right. So H is the vertical height, the height which must be in meters. So height must be in meters.